Hello everyone, welcome you all in the online lectures. In previous lecture we discussed the basic components of a colorimetry, that means the block diagram of the instrumentation of
colorimetry,
it containing a radiation source. Second one is called as a monochromators or filters. Then third one is sample holder, then detector, and the last one is readout device. In last lecture we also discussed a cross view of this
colorimetry,
which is used in this
colorimetry,
and the radiation source. Radiation source is nothing but the device which can use a radiation in the ultraviolet as well as visible region, where the light is required for the absorption of light. And for that visible region we can use a tungsten filament lamp. Then we discuss how the tungsten filament lamp is constructed and its working, its advantage and as well as disadvantage. Then instead of this tungsten filament lamp, we can use a carbon arc lamp for the visible region, and for ultraviolet region we can use hydrogen lamp, deuterium lamp, xenon discharge lamp, or sometimes a mercury arc lamp can be used. Then we also discuss about control of radiant power. So in control of radiant power we can use lenses, mirrors as well as slits. So mirrors can be used to collect the all radiation and travel in one direction. Lenses, that is collimating lens, is used to make the beam parallel. And slits can be used to adjust the bandwidth, or we can say that to adjust the narrow beam, and which can be used to obey the Beer's law to avoid the stray light, and the sensitivity can be increased, right? So these are all about the control of radiation power. Now in this lecture we will be discuss about the filters and monochromator, that is second components of this instrument, second component which is used in spectrophotometer, that is filters and monochromators. Filters and monochromators, these are the two different terms. So filters are nothing but these are the device which can be only transmit a desired wavelength of light, that means it only filter the light. So it will be absorb the all other radiation and it will be travel a particular light, that means it gives a bandwidth of light near about 25 nanometer, that means it cannot gives a single wavelength of light, and therefore these are called as the filters. A radiation source is generally emitting a continuous spectra, that is it gives all possible wavelength of light. That means suppose we are seeing the visible light, the light will be emitted by the radiation source from 400 to 800 nanometers. But the 400 to 800 nanometer, among these light if we require a particular wavelength of light, and for that we require a filters and monochromators, right? So however, a narrow band of wavelength is always necessary in colorimetry as well as spectrophotometric analysis. Narrow band of the wavelength, that means suppose we require a 580 nanometer wavelength, and for the 580 nanometer wavelength we can use a narrow bandwidth, that is plus or minus 10 nanometer, or sometimes plus or minus 25 nanometer, called as a bandwidth, right? So therefore it is necessary to have a device which will select a narrow band from the wavelength of the continuous spectrum, and for this purpose we require filters and monochromators. For a narrow band from the wavelength we are using filters and monochromators. So among these filters and monochromator, first we will see what are the filters. Filters are nothing but these are the light filter is a device that allows light of required wavelength to pass but absorb the light of other wavelength. And the other wavelength will be wholly absorbed or sometimes partially absorbed, and thus a given filters can select a particular wavelength band, particular wavelength of band. These are called as filters, right? So filters are nothing but these are the device which can be absorbed or fully or partially absorbed of the all other radiations and travel only a light which is required for the analysis. There are two types of filters are used, that is called as a absorption filter, and second is called as a interference filter. So what is absorption filter? Absorption filter nothing but these filters works on a selective absorption of unwanted wavelength. Suppose we are using a light in the ultraviolet and visible region, and here if we require a particular wavelength of light, it will be absorb a particular wavelength of light, and it will be absorb all other radiation and only travel a particular wavelength of light, right? So those filter limit radiation by absorbing certain portion of the light spectrum, and the selective absorption is illustrated. The selective absorption is like this. That means, suppose this is a filter which is called as a green color glass plate, right? And if we travel a polychromatic light through this filter, polychromatic light may be containing 400 to 800 nanometer or 750 nanometer, and when this light will be traveled through the absorption spectrum, it will be absorb all radiation and only travel the 500 to 560 nanometer, because green filter is there, the wavelength of green filter is between 500 to 560 nanometer. It will be absorb all other radiation and only travel the 500 to 560 nanometer, that is plus or minus 30 nanometer wavelength of light is passing through this filter. So its construction is again very simple. It is a consist of solid sheet of a glass that has been colored by means of pigment or gelatin coated on a glass or a plastic. Suppose a plastic or glass plate is there, and into that glass plate or plastic plate the colored pigment is coated. So different types of color, that is green, red, black, blue, violet. So different colors are coated on this glass plate, because every color having capacity to transmit a particular wavelength of light and it will be absorb all other radiation. And the color pigments are nothing but the color pigments are sometimes the gelatin is coated. A colored solution of inorganic salts or sometimes organic dyes can also be used for the filters. That means a color compound or color pigments or gelatin, colored inorganic salts or sometimes organic dyes can be coated on the filters, and these absorption filters are generally used in the visible region, that is 400 to 800 nanometer, right? So these absorption filters are generally used in the visible region, that is 400 to 800 nanometers, right? Then these are characterized by peak transmittance and band pass width of the wavelength. Peak transmittance and band pass width. Then the usual glass filter have 35 to 50 nanometer band pass width, right? 35 to 50 nanometer band pass width, that is plus or minus up to the 25 nanometer band pass width is there. Then to get a narrower range of the wavelength, sometimes a combination of filters can be also used. Then the band pass width can be reduced from 35 to 50 nanometer, and for that we are using a combination of filters. So this is a peak transmittance and band pass width. Suppose we are using a wavelength of light in the visible region, and when the absorption filter is placed, so it having a peak transmitter, that means it having near about absorption value at the wavelength. Suppose it is a 560 nanometer wavelength, then the peak transmittance will be observed at the 560 nanometer, but the band pass width will be from 35 to 50 nanometer band pass width, right? Then every colorimeter is provided with a set of 12 filters. Suppose we are taking a device that is called as a colorimeter, and if we are using this colorimeter, the colorimeter will be provided a 12 set of filters with a peak transmittance, and absorption filters are generally cheaper than the interference filter. The absorption filters, which are prepared by a coating of color pigment, color dyes or color compounds on the glass plate, and there are 12 set of filters can be provided with the instrument that is called as a colorimeter. Then the second type of filter is called as an interference filter. Interference filter is quite different than the absorption filter, because in absorption filter it will be absorb all other radiation and only transmit the particular wavelength of light. But in interference filter, it works on the interference phenomena. Then the shorter wavelength becomes a longer wavelength, and longer wavelength becomes a shorter wavelength. That means these filters generally provide a somewhat narrower bandwidth, as low as 10 nanometer. In absorption filter, the band pass width is 35 to 50 nanometer, but in interference that will be reduced up to the 10 nanometer as compared to the absorption filters. In order to prepare the filter, the filters can be prepared by a very simple way. That is, a semi-transparent metal film is deposited on a glass plate. A semi-transparent metal film is coated on the glass plate. Then it is coated with a thin layer of some dielectric transparent material like magnesium fluoride. Then suppose there is a glass plate. Over this glass plate we are placing a semi-transparent metal plate like a silver. Then over this some dielectric transparent material that is magnesium fluoride is coated and followed by another coating of a thin film of the metal, and then there is again a glass plate will be used for the mechanical protection, right? So if we see the construction, initially there is a glass plate. Over the glass plate we are taking a semi-transparent metal like silver, then magnesium fluoride, then again metal silver plate is coated, and again there is a glass plate for the mechanical protection. So this is the construction of this interference filter. Then this filter works under the interference phenomena at desired wavelength, and this will be neglecting unwanted radiation by the selective reflection. Then when a ray of light is transmitted through the filter, then the part of light will be reflected back, whereas the remaining light will be transmitted, right? If we see its diagram, in the diagram we can see clear how to the light will be reflect and how it can be transmitted to the sample. The part of the incident radiation is reflected repeated by the semi-transparent metal film, but at each reflection some radiations are transmitted out. That is, the part of incident radiation is reflected repeatedly by the semi-transparent metal film. There is semi-transparent metal film is there, so that will be reflect the incident radiation, and some of the light will be transmitted through this metal film. The outgoing radiation undergoes constructive interference, because we know that the interference filter will be works on the interference phenomenon, that is constructive interference, and for those wavelengths which are exactly even multiple of distance separating by the two metal films, that means it works on the constructive interference. And for remaining wavelength, the radiation beam undergo a destructive interference, and thus corresponding energy is not pass out. Because the constructive interference, will be takes place, and due to that the radiation will be transmitted through the semi-dielectric material, but those remaining radiation will be undergoes destructive interference, and that will be not passed through the dielectric material, and that will be reflect back. So by varying the distance between the metal film, suppose the distance between two metal film is changed, then the wavelength range can be modified, right? So how it can be takes place, that again seen by the equation. So here is the construction of the interference filter. So its construction will be shows that at the inner part is nothing but the semi electric transparent medium like magnesium fluoride. So this is a central part. Over the central part there is a second part is called as a semi transparent metal film, that is silver, and then it is coated by means of two glass plate. That means there are two glass plate. In between glass plate there is a semi-transparent metal film, and between semi-transparent metal film there is a semi-dielectric material, right? If we see the transparent spacer, its distance is equal to one half lambda. That means whatever wavelength is required is one half of the distance between transparent spacer, and if we change the distance then the wavelength can be changed. So the equation which gives the wavelength of the transmitted radiation is given by equation m lambda is equal to 2d n into sin theta. M lambda 2d n sin theta. So that means the equation which is gives the wavelength, so wavelength is that is called as a lambda, that lambda can be taken by the equation m lambda is equal to 2d sin theta, where lambda is the wavelength of transmitted light. Lambda is the wavelength of transmitted light. M is the order of reflection, that is whole number multiple of the transmitted wavelength. Then d is called as the distance of the separated metal film. N is called as the refractive index of the spacer, that is magnesium fluoride, and theta is called as the angle of incidence. So if you see the diagram here, so this diagram will be shows that, so here is the light, polychromatic light will be incident on this interference filter, making an angle of theta. So this theta angle is formed, that is called as a theta angle of incident. Then so this is the wavelength, so these two dot will be shows wavelength, and that wavelength is calculated by using formula m lambda is equal to 2d n psi theta. So this d is called as a distance of the spacer, that is the, we can suppose we are using a transparent spacer, that is magnesium fluoride, and its distance is called as a d. N is called as the refractive index of this transparent spacer, right? And it can be works on the constructive interference. That means the polychromatic light when they transmitted through this spacer, it only allows the lambda light will be travel through this and other light will be reflected. So here will be makes a constructive interference. If the shorter wavelength is there, it will be forms a constructive interference, and that constructive interference it will be travel the light. If the radiation is more than the wavelength, then it will be used a destructive interference, and due to that remaining light will be reflected, and only it allows the light of the transmitted light will be travel through this sample solution. So what we discussed today, we discuss a absorption filter as well as interference filter. Absorption filters are nothing but these are made up from the glass plate or plastic plate which is coated by the colored pigments, colored dyes, sometimes a colored inorganic salts. Then it will be only allows a particular wavelength of the light that is complementary to the color, and all other light will be absorbed. That is called as an absorption filter, and its band pass width is 35 to 50 nanometer. Second is called as the interference filter. The interference filter will be works on the phenomenon of constructive interference and destructive interference. Then it is made up from the semi-transparent dielectric material, that is magnesium fluoride. Over this, a semi-transparent metal like silver is deposited, and over this two glass plates are there to give a mechanical strength. And if we incident the light on the polychromatic light on the this filter, it will be gives a constructive interference, and the light which is travel through this interference filter given by the equation m lambda is equal to 2dn sin theta. That means if we want a particular wavelength of light, we can change the distance of this spacer, and according to that the wavelength can be varies, right? So friends, let us stop here. The remaining part regarding to the instrumentation spectrophotometer discussing next lecture. Thank you.